Dear students, assalamu alaikum and welcome to grade 9. From Noor School and College Mansehra, I am your teacher Muhammad Awais Kashmiri. Dear students, as you know that we are discussing unit number 2 and we are discussing exercise of unit number 2. In previous lecture, as you know that we have discussed what is a prefix, what is suffix and use of pronoun. So as you people already know that prefix is a set of letters which is included before a word to make new word, and suffix is used after words to make new words. So these are actually words formation processes. These are actually words formation processes. So dear students, then we used different kinds of pronouns. Today we are going to discuss use of indefinite pronoun. Number one, use of indefinite pronoun, pronoun and its antecedent, pronoun and its antecedent, and anaphoric and cataphoric references. Anaphoric and cataphoric references. Dear students, now we come towards the book, page number 22. See, put the following indefinite pronouns in the correct blanks. Dear students, look at these words: anywhere, anyone, something, everyone, nothing, somewhere, someone, anything, everything. These are actually pronouns. But which pronouns? These are indefinite pronouns. So now I am going to tell you that what is an indefinite pronoun, which does not tell you something definite, which does not tell you about definite thing. So dear student, for example, we have word anywhere. So it is giving reference of some specific place? No. So it is indefinite. Indefinite. Anywhere. So which place we are talking about? We don't know. So it is indefinite place. So anywhere is an indefinite pronoun. Anyone. So it can be anyone. You don't know about a specific person, so it is also indefinite pronoun. Similarly, something, you don't know about a specific thing, everyone, nothing, somewhere, someone, anything, everything. So these are indefinite pronouns. Means these pronouns does not tell you about something or some place or some person definite. Okay. Now we are using these indefinite pronouns in blanks. Can't you hear that Dash is knocking on the door? Someone is knocking on the door. So someone is the correct option for this blank. I was wondering if you would like something to drink. So something is an indefinite pronoun, which is the correct option for this blank. The family members have been badly injured in the accident. Is there anyone to help them? Anyone is the correct option for this blank. Seema has just checked the internet. However, she couldn't find the article anywhere. She couldn't find the article anywhere. Anywhere is the correct option. Unfortunately, this plant is already dead and there is nothing we can do about it. There is nothing we can do about it. Nothing is the correct option. Now we are going toward the next part. Underline the pronoun in each sentence below. Circle the antecedent the pronoun refers to. So dear student, now we are coming toward the point that what is a pronoun and what is its antecedent. Dear students, look at the example. Look at the example. Asma often plays with her doll. Asma often plays with her doll. So here we have a pronoun, her, which is used for this noun Asma. So it means that this pronoun is referring to Asma. This pronoun is referring to Asma. This is pronoun and this would be antecedent. So now we are coming toward the thing that what is an antecedent? An antecedent is a word which for which pronoun stands. An antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. So here is the word Asma. For this word, for this noun, pronoun her is standing. So Asma is antecedent of the pronoun her. Are you clear with this? Asma often plays with her doll. So pronoun her is standing for this word. So her, we have pronoun, and antecedent would be the word for which this her is standing. So antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. I hope you people are clear with it. Now I am coming toward the definition. An antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. An antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. So this is antecedent because for this word a pronoun is standing. Okay, now this is pronoun and this is antecedent. Dear students, do remember two more things. Pronoun must agree with its antecedent in number. Singular pronoun must replace a singular pronoun and plural must replace a plural pronoun. So what do you mean by this? It means that now look here, Asma is singular. Asma is a singular noun and for singular noun we have used her. Suppose you have two names here, Asma and Rabia. Asma and Rabia. Then you cannot use her for two girls because then they will be plural and we will use their doll. Asma and Rabia often plays with their doll because there is a need of agreement between antecedent and the pronoun. Number of antecedents will tell you that which pronoun you are going to use. Okay, I hope you are clear with this thing. Asma is antecedent and for this word a pronoun is standing her, so it is pronoun. A word for which pronoun stands is actually the antecedent. Now we are coming towards the exercise. Underline the pronoun in each sentence below. Circle the antecedent the pronoun refers to. Saima walked to the park. She enjoyed jumping on the trampoline. So here is the word Saima and she is pronoun. So what he is actually saying, underline the pronoun. So we underlined the pronoun. Okay, circle the antecedent the pronoun refers to. So this pronoun is referring to this antecedent, so I underlined this. Got it? This is pronoun and this is antecedent. Shama loves to walk on the beach. She watches the sunset often. She is pronoun and Shama is antecedent. Daud enjoys playing basketball. He knows that it is his favorite sport. Daud. So for Daud here pronoun is used he. So I underlined he and I encircled Daud. which is antecedent of he. And basketball, for basketball here he has used it, so it is pronoun and basketball is its antecedent. Abrar, Jamal and Manan. So now we have three words, three nouns. Enjoy playing cricket. Enjoy playing cricket. So they love teamwork. Here they is used for these plural antecedents. So we also need agreement with antecedent, and we also need agreement between antecedent and pronoun. So there is the pronoun and its antecedents are Abrar, Jamal and Manan. The shopper couldn't find his car in the parking lot. So his is used for the shopper. So his is pronoun and the shopper is antecedent. So I encircled the antecedent and underlined the pronoun. I hope you people are clear with the pronoun and the antecedent. Now we are moving toward the next part, which is anaphoric and cataphoric references. Anaphoric and cataphoric references. Dear student, look at the example. I went out with Jamila on Sunday. She looked confused. So Jamila and she. Okay. Now look at this example. When he arrived, Ashraf noticed that the door was open. Dear student, look here. Here antecedent is used first and pronoun is used later. And here pronoun is used first and antecedent is used later. So first we are looking at anaphoric references. Anaphoric reference means that a word in a text refers back to another word. Means a word refers, means that a word in text refers to a word which is at its back. A word in a text that refers back to another word for its meaning. So if I use word she, you don't know about whom I am talking about. So you need to look back for which word I have used she. So for Jamila, I have word used she. When you look back for meaning of pronoun, when you look back for some word of the sentence to find meaning of the first word, then it is anaphoric reference. Then it is anaphoric reference. So I have gone back to search the meaning that who is she? Who is she? So when we go back, then it is anaphoric reference. And look here, when he arrived, Ashraf noticed that the door was open. So it is cataphoric reference. It means that a word in a text refers to another word later in the text. So he is referring to the word which comes later, and then we are clear that who is he. Ashraf is actually he. So when we go back for some information, then is anaphoric reference, and then we come forward for information, then it is cataphoric reference. I hope you people are clear with these two examples. Now, I went out with Jamila on Sunday. She looked confused. In this example, the pronoun she is anaphoric reference. She is anaphoric reference because it refers to the noun Jamila that is introduced earlier in the text. So Jamila is introduced earlier in the text and she is used for Jamila later. So it is, she is an anaphoric reference. In next example, when he arrived, Ashraf noticed that the door was open. In this example, the pronoun he is cataphoric reference. He is cataphoric reference because it refers to the noun. It refers to the noun Ashraf that is introduced later in the text. That is introduced later in the text. So it is a cataphoric reference, which is introduced earlier. Anaphoric reference, which is introduced later, is cataphoric reference. So dear students, I hope that you people are clear with anaphoric and cataphoric references. Dear students, now I am going to sum up this for you, that what we have learned today, use of indefinite pronoun. So I have already told you people that indefinite pronoun is a kind of pronoun which does not tell you about definite things like someone, anyone, anything, something. Then we learned that what is pronoun and what is its antecedent. So an antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. An antecedent is a word for which pronoun stands. So look here, Samina walked to the park. She enjoyed jumping on the trampoline. So she, for this she, Samina is the explanation, means this is the word for which this pronoun is used. So she is pronoun and Saima is its antecedent. And then we move towards anaphoric and cataphoric references. So anaphoric reference means when a word in a text is at the back side and we complete information about the word and we go backward to know about the word, that whom actually we are talking about. So going backward is anaphoric reference, and going forward is cataphoric reference. So we went forward to know that who is he. So it is cataphoric reference. So I hope you people are clear with the use of indefinite pronoun, pronoun and its antecedent, anaphoric and cataphoric references. So now I am giving you people a homework, which is very simple. Write 5 sentences and underline the pronoun while circle its antecedent. Example is given for you people. Ali said that he has passed the exam. So here he is pronoun and Ali is its antecedent. Dear students, I hope you people are clear with today's lecture. If you face any sort of problem, you can contact me personally. Thank you so much for watching. Kindly do this homework, kindly write these homework on your notebooks and send it to me. Thank you so much.